Hello, everyone, and welcome to Math 113 in the spring of 2017. I wanted to go over a few things with you to introduce you to the class. The start is Blackboard is our course website. This is where you're going to find everything you need. This is what Blackboard should look like for you when you get into our course. The announcements are going to be front and center. Most important place probably is the assignments and modules. So if you click on that, you're going to get into all of the things you need to complete for this class. For starters, you're going to need to complete the syllabus quiz. That means you're going to need to go to the Syllabus and Schedule tab and complete it there. When you click on Syllabus and Schedule, you will get to the point where you have that syllabus and schedule available to you. You should read through the whole thing, and we're going to talk about a few key points in a second. But back to the assignments and modules, complete that quiz, and then each module has its own folder. On the front of the folder, you're going to see an outline of exactly what is due and when. In each folder, the most important thing, here's a little overview. There's a question of the week. You can read through that. But the most important thing is that there is a video and some accompanying notes that go for every single section. You should be watching these. Everybody should. This is just like coming to class. Instead of coming to a set class time, you get to do this on your own time and watch the videos. These are videos that I have made and that are available to you at any time. Then, at the end of that, you should go and do your My Math Lab homework first. To do that, you click on the My Math Lab online homework. That's going to bring you to this page where you can click on the assignments, and it's going to get you logged in the first time. It's going to take a few minutes to get you, but you need that access code. And that's where your assignments are going to be completed. Those are the things you should do the first, and those are due on Thursdays. Then the written homework is next. Those are due on Saturdays. Right here is a list of all of the homework and when it's due. Next is a video, because I need you to turn in your homework in one combined PDF. That's the way Blackboard views it, is in PDF mode. I can't see it in any other mode, and having more than one file just makes it difficult to grade. So this video tutorial will help you do that. If you need homework help, you can click here, or on the left hand side there's also a homework help option, and there is help additional videos and web pages for each section that might help you out. Each homework that's due, there's a link. This is where you submit it, so you click on this and you're going to submit your homework there. And when they're ready, the written homework solutions will be posted a few days after each one is due, and you can look over those. It's also going to include the suggested problems, not just the problems to turn in. This is the written homework list. Important to note, the problems over here on the last column, these are the ones I actually want to see you give to me. The problems to turn in, those are the ones you show to me. The suggested problems are all the problems that I hope you complete and I will give you solutions for. But you don't have to turn them all in. I wanted a subset. But you certainly need to do more than just these six problems in order to get a good grasp on these sections. Now let's take a quick look at the syllabus. My important information is there. Office hours, I need every one of you to email me, preferably from your alaska.edu email, and tell me which of the times that are in the syllabus quiz that you would like to have office hours. Secondly, it's very important that everybody has the textbook within the first week, or at least access to My Math Lab. My Math Lab does allow you, I believe, 2 weeks for free, so there's no excuse for getting your work done. Go ahead and get started, even if you're waiting for your textbook. Homework policies. I'm the most lenient with late homework on My Math Lab. For that, you can have up to 3 weekly homeworks extended throughout the course. I don't need a reason. It doesn't need to be a good one. But I'm only going to give you 3. If you need more than 3 extended, you will get zeros on the rest. So use this opportunity wisely. Written homework. It's important to get these in on time for my grading and for your actual completion. So I will accept 1 late written homework without penalty. After that, it'll be 5 points off for the next assignment, 10 points for the third, etc. You know, 15 for the fourth, and so on. Late quizzes, these are the most important to have in on time of everything, because these are mini tests and you need to have the material at the time that you're actually completing the material in order for it to make sense. So late quizzes are allowed, but they will be penalized 50% of their original point value. And that is going to be shown in my gradebook. It's going to take a while for that to be reflected in the gradebook on Blackboard, just because of the way those items come in. Late midterm exams, not allowed. So if you have an extreme circumstance, you're hospitalized, something like that happens, if you give me proof, you can take a makeup exam. Otherwise, I need to know about any issues with your scheduling ahead of time, and we can work those out, preferably that you take it earlier rather than later. Lastly, the last thing to note is that I will take your final exam if it's higher than one of your midterm scores. So if you screw up a midterm, your life is not over. If you do well on your final exam and you keep up on your written homework and get at least a 60% on both, then I will take that final exam score and put it in for your midterm exam instead. So you have an opportunity to make up. That means that hope is not lost and it will always be available. On exams, calculator is allowed. It has to be a real calculator. You're not going to be able to use your cell phone because that has internet capabilities and you can't be looking stuff up while you're taking an exam. And anything else, they're not going to allow you in. iPods, headphones, cell phones, all those things they're not going to allow you to have in the testing center. If you can't take an exam at the testing center in Fairbanks, you need to set up your own proctor, and there are instructions on doing that. Okay, that about covers everything I wanted to go over with you. Welcome to the course, and please feel free to email me, call, or text if you have any questions.